Thanks a lot, Chris. These nights, they happen in the NBA, right? Where no matter how good a team is, no matter how hot they are, how cold the other team is, you can lose on any given night. And when one team shoots over 50% from three and hits 21 of them, and the other team shoots 27% from three, usually the team who had the hot shooting night is going to win, and that's what happened in Orlando tonight.
Yeah, and I think we would have guessed if we saw those numbers that it would have been the opposite team shooting as efficiently as they did. But give Orlando credit. They played last night against the Knicks here in New York. They got back home, and they brought a high level of energy, of focus, and they were just really efficient really on both ends of the floor. And for the Nets, sometimes it's just not your night, and particularly down the stretch once they made that push and once we saw a little bit of juice and some more chemistry created, they got incredible looks, and they got looks for shooters that are normally knockdown players, and they just didn't go in. And I think that really was the story of the night in a lot of facets of sometimes the ball's just not going to go in for you. It's not your night. And for the Magic, they finally find a way to break a streak, and on a losing streak that is that long, a team can always be dangerous, especially when they return home.
And I do think back to what Steve Nash said before the game. He said, hey, when he was presented with some positive defensive numbers that Brooklyn's had during this 15-game stretch, he said, you know, we need to continue to play with a chip on our shoulder like we're an underdog in order to have a chance to be good at the defensive end. We saw that in the fourth quarter. They turned it on. But because they didn't hit the shots, it wasn't enough. But maybe a little bit of a lesson, Sarah, regardless of the opponent, you got to come out of the gates with that mentality.
Yeah, and I think for Brooklyn, they have been so focused throughout the course of this stretch the last couple weeks. And so it is natural at times to have a bit of a letdown. And I think we saw some of that in just the idea of always thinking, okay, we're going to be able to get this back. At some point, this team is going to cool off, or at some point, we're going to start to get hot. And none of those things ended up coming together in the same manner as you would expect. And, you know, Kyrie Irving, a sparkling night of what he did on the offensive side. But we've been coming out a lot of these games saying, oh, five players in double figures, six players and double figures didn't just happen this evening. And I think it's a learning experience, areas of which you grow. And for the Nets, you know, this is a long season, and we've seen a lot of winning, but anticipate that they're going to get back to that when they have a chance to see a very hot team right now, and a team that's going to come in hungry in the Washington Wizards behind Bradley Beal and Russell Westbrook.
Yeah, Harden against Westbrook, Bradley Beal, the NBA's leading scorer. Going to be a really fun matchup on Sunday night here at Barclays Center between the Nets and the Wizards, as we send things back to you in the studio.